Jesus.
Excuse me.
I'm not tired.
I'll get out here.
Oh, hello.
He wouldn't have made it on his own. You're a piece of work.
I would calm down, Nini.
I don't want to calm down.
Then go for a walk until you do.
I don't want to go for a walk. You made me your deputy and you've never given me credit.
That's not true.
Have you looked at the masthead lately? There's one name on it.
There's always been one
but
name.
But you act as if you wrote every article and stayed up all night to print the bloody
as
thing.
As editor...
When have you ever said, good job, Nini, that was a great idea? Fuck! Don't... You talk to Nolene.
Yes.
Make sure it's good copy. I'm putting her on the cover.
Nolene, not Hoax and Linda.
Everyone will have them. Our readers are women, Marcus. So I'm putting on the old wife who drained his sack, had his kids, washed his undies, and then he left. That's who our readers want. Oh, Marcus, I'm going to airbrush Nolene so she looks better than hell.
They've had a splendid flight so far, I think.
Oh, when they put a few hundred million dollars where their mouths are, we'll have a splendid flight as well.
And to those who are jealous of those with more money, do not just sit there and complain. Do something to make more money for yourself. There is no monopoly on becoming a millionaire. Spend less time drinking or smoking and socializing and more time working. This age of entitlement and its consequences is creating problems for all of us.
You told her the child died.
It was the most sensible thing to do.
Really?
The girl needed an end to her false hope. Oh, Jesus. Who are you worried about, her or yourself?
I'd rather she wasn't destroyed.
I have lied for you. I have falsified records, all because you needed to give your wife a child and couldn't wait. I had nothing, Chris. You were losing weight, jaundiced, hungry, sick all the time. You nearly died. It was all for you, to protect you.
Protect me? By leaving me with a couple of sadists. She treated me like shit. And her old man used to beat me with a brass buckle for the smallest thing. Even when you could have come back, you didn't.
I didn't want to ruin what you had. I've never stopped loving you.
Mr. Pack and Mr. Singleton called.
So?
He said he'd call back.
About what?
He didn't say. He was...
Well, bloody well find out. And where were you on Tuesday night? I thought I told you, you have to be here if I'm here.
Mr. Packer, it was 10 o'clock at night.
Did you hear what I just said?
It was my birthday. They were all waiting for me.
Do you want this job or not?
Of course.